Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to talk to you about 5 ways to sell more stock photos or vectors. And you're probably wondering, what is wrong with my eye? Well, I'll tell you what happened. We play volleyball, and my husband and I both went for the same ball, and his arm hit my face, and this is the result. So anyway, back to the task at hand, which is talking about stock vectors and photos and how to sell more of them. So first off is to really pay attention to new words out there, like slang words or maybe new news terms or anything like that. A good example of this was a few years ago was Brexit. This was a word that was completely made up. Of course, there's not going to be any existing images about Brexit out there. And so if you hear a word like that, or your friends are saying words that maybe you haven't heard before, take note of those and try to see, do a little research and see if there's been images created for those words. Some new words I've seen in the last few years, something like facepalm or froyo, or maybe even like hangry, anything like that, you could try to create some images around that. Put them out on the stock sites and see if they sell. Number 2, create an image every single day. Personally, I use a Google Calendar to keep track of how many images I've created so far. And if I miss a day, I will go back and I'll make up that day. So at the end of the year, I will absolutely have 365 new images in my portfolio. Now, this isn't easy, but there are a lot of benefits to it. You start kind of getting in a zone with what you're creating. You get better as an artist or a photographer. It starts being a lot more easy and a lot more fun. So an image a day is the way to go. And I think you'll see a huge increase in your sales, of course, if you have 365 new images in your portfolio. Number 3, upload your images once a week. Now, if you've been creating once every day, you'll have about 6 or 7 images to upload. And if you upload at the same time every week, this will get you in kind of a rhythm with the stock agencies. And I think, I am not 100% sure about this, but I think it helps your ranking. So if someone searches for those keywords, you will rank higher than someone else who doesn't upload once a week, because the internet loves consistency. YouTube loves it if creators publish a video once a week. Google loves it if you blog 2 or 3 times a week or more. And I would guess that the stock sites also love it for you to be consistent with how often you upload. So that is my 3rd tip. Number 4, submit your images to more than one stock site. In my personal experience and all over the internet, everyone says their best 3 sales sites are Shutterstock, Adobe Stock, and iStock. So if you can get your images on those 3 sites at least, and then later branch out to even more sites like Dreamstime, 123RS, and a lot of the smaller sites like Big Stock, Can Stock, any of those, basically the more images you have in the more places, the more you're gonna sell. It just makes sense. Now, it does get a little tedious to upload 7 images to 10 different stock sites. That's 70 images every week, and it is time consuming, but I think it's worth it. Now, if you've decided to be an exclusive seller through iStock or one of the other sites, that means you cannot put your images on any other stock site. So be mindful of that. If you're exclusive, you can't actually branch out to any other sites. Now, my last tip is for those of you who have been doing this a while. Almost all the stock sites have statistics areas where you can go and see your most popular images, the ones that are selling the best, and your least popular images. So what I want you to do is figure out your 5 most popular images and then create 10 more images around those same ideas. So let's say your best-selling image is a tacos icon set, and you've got little tacos that look a little bit different or whatever. Sketch out 10 new ideas for tacos that don't have anything to do with those tacos, but they're still about tacos, right? So sketch those out and then create those images. Or if you're a photographer, create new tacos images. The reason that your tacos images are selling so well is probably because there is a lower competition in that area. So if you create 10 more, those will probably sell pretty well too. Now you're probably thinking, well, isn't that competitive against myself? But different stock users need different things. So your tacos icon set might not work for them, but some other taco image would. So you're appealing to that person and every other person who might not need the icon set. So don't limit yourself to just thinking they're only going to want your one image that is selling so well. Okay, everyone, that is my video for this week. I'm sorry you had to look at my eye for 5 minutes or however long this video turns out to be. I will see you next Thursday. If you like this video, please click on the like button. And if you make some images around froyo, facepalm, and hangry, please leave a comment in the comment section below and let me know how they're doing. And especially if you sell some, I would love to know that too. Thanks, everyone, and I'll see you next week.